A lot of people ask us, like, why do you do it in Detroit? They don't understand that there are people out here who live in the city and who are interested in creativity and art and skateboarding and music, and if we build, they will come, kind of thing.
Basically, we just wanted to do something different, something that involves not just the skateboard community, but just the overall creative community. Levi's is looking to support a skate scene within the country, in mentioned Detroit. Really, I don't think this could have happened without them being involved. It's an art gallery and a movie theater slash event space. People can play music, show videos, skate videos, or motion pictures. Within these environments, we've dispersed skateable elements. When you come in, it's not supposed to look like a skate park. We want them to think, oh, there's these kind of like organic shaped obstacles or walls in here. The idea was just to make it so you could skate without stopping through all three rooms. So you could just start in one room, then you can flow through the art gallery, then flow into the movie theater and the event space, then flow out of that back into the gallery. We've also made it so you can move all of the obstacles. So all of them are removable or can be moved in different ways to create different combinations of possibilities, skateboarding wise. Yeah! Boom! The name Rosa Parks Boys, it came about because we all live on Rosa Parks Boulevard, which is just down the street from the space. And the name just started as a complete joke, and now this came about, and it just seemed fitting to name this Rosa Parks Boys as well. This space is in Detroit's oldest neighborhood, which is called Corktown. This was originally a house for a very prominent Detroiter. The earliest record of it is 1873.
When we first got it, it was an empty, just run-down, basically, warehouse.
The work involved was just so tedious and dirty.
We just had to start from scratch and basically slowly clean everything out. We had an idea on how to build ramps, obviously, just growing up skating, but we winged it.
Levi's and Skateboard Mag's involvement definitely made this happen a lot sooner than it normally would have.
It's not that hard. It's like, everyone can do it. Just like, make it happen.
As everyone knows, Detroit has its own share of hardships and difficulties and problems, and it's definitely not the easiest city to live in, but at the same time, I kind of feel like the difficulties that Detroit does present also motivates and inspires the people here to do something, to make a change.
The people that live in this neighborhood, they want to be here. If someone's trying to open something and they have passion, everyone's going to support them. It's great to give them a space so they can have a dinner party, have a birthday party, have a music venue. Like, this is more than just skateboarding. It's more than just an art gallery. It's just like, it's a hub for creativity, I guess.